Hello guys, I'm the Canadian Reviewer doing a new video review for you guys, and this time we're taking a look at a toy that should have been reviewed 11 months ago. The reason why I'm doing it now is so I don't have to say, well, I got it a year ago exactly and now I'm only doing the review. I want to do the review now, so let's go ahead and do the review now. This is Transformers Dark of the Moon. Skids, let's take a closer look at it, shall we?
Oh, look at this bundle of joy! Look at this! Look at this! Do you like our reflective floor? Ooh! Now that's sexy. Now, as you can see, Skids is a Chevy Spark, obviously. Yes, there's a new version of the Chevy Spark. Unfortunately, his buddy, the Chevy Trax, or what? Was it the Chevy. Like. I don't know, either way, the Chevy Spark came out, and I guess they wanted to put it in Dark of the Moon. Now, a lot of people say that these guys are racist, but I really didn't see that. I saw them as, like, hillbillies. I don't know, is that racist, too? Is hillbilly a race now? But they weren't really too bad to me. I think they were fine. And I would love to see them in Dark of the Moon, and I just honestly don't see them as... black. And then I came to the realization that in Dark of the Moon, those people would have been right. I mean, look at him now. He's black now. And it's not like they stopped hair. It's not like they stopped there. His brother is black too, so... And as you can see, he has visible head syndrome, not on the bottom like usual, but on the front screen, so, you know, he can have fun watching himself, you know, drive. According to the comics, these two were supposed to die by Sentinel Prime. I personally don't think that was going to happen. I think they just tried to axe them off so that no questions could be made. That's just my personal opinion. I actually think that these two were supposed to be in Dark of the Moon and supposed to live through Dark of the Moon, be the comedic geniuses. And a lot of people will say that's kind of a good thing that they weren't in the movie, but I just found Dark of the Moon kind of boring. That's my personal opinion. Alright, shut up. I'm gonna get lots of hate mail. Anyways, you can plug on the weapon and both ports go sucked into itself, it's a black hole, and you can activate the mech tech, which is, like, woohoo. And, there's really not much to be said. Nice silver and gold paint details, nothing on the rims, unfortunately, but it's still a fine dandy little alt mode. So let's go to robot mode. And here's Skids in his robot mode, and, wow, could you imagine if these two had a talk show? Whoring out of the other show. Actually, could you imagine if these two had a drama?
What you talking about? You're not my brother. Yes, I am. I'm so your brother.
Really? Then why does the birth certificate say that we're not my brother?
We have different mothers. And yet, somehow we're twins.
Why'd you decide to come live with me in my apartment to play video games?
Because I had nowhere else to go. It was very lonely. Some bad times. I did some things, man. I did some things. I had a rat. It was not good. I didn't even have pepper.
Dumb. So anyways, let's take a look at the goodies and the baddies of these two. What, you want a meme? The Turkish is the pizza. Yeah, that's... What? No! So you can't plug on the mech tech weapon. Let's talk about the mech tech weapon for a sec. I'm not a big fan of when it's not activated because you get these two huge pieces. I guess that's engine parts, but it's not really used to make an engine, so it's just there. However, when it's deployed, you can see the works. The works! That's...
the MechTech weapon is supposed to do, and you see the magic behind the development, behind its technology, and it reveals to you, well, it's just this stupid little thing, actually. It's just, whatever. I will say it's one of the better MechTechs, and you can plug it on there in this very loose ball joint that just flops around. Yes, that's the place that I put it on, apparently. And you can have it as a handgun, which looks kind of cool. Or you can not... Oh, you can plug it on his hand. Okay. And something that I don't like is his... It looks like this piece is supposed to completely go through so that, you know, if you got some longer peg, that this panel will kind of help it hold into place. But it's off. And when you got it in alt mode, it's not like it's used for anything, but it is a MechTech port. So, yeah, that's kind of pointless. You can even take this off, and it's like, oh, that. Even has a MechTech port on the top here. I don't know if that's supposed to be, like, storage, but, hey, that's kind of cool. Let's take a look at his head for a sec. His head is actually quite nice. He's got this little bulky look. And he's got wicked huge feet, look at that. Oh, and you complained about an incinerator. Yeah, look at that. Now, if you don't like the backpack, you can do a little something for that. It just pops off. It pops off there, and it pops off here, so there's like two places to where you can pop it off. Isn't that magical? I will say, though, my biggest complaint is that the waist does not plug into itself, so it constantly snaps out. And the arms, they don't really have a place to go, but I guess that's okay. I'm not a huge fan on how these arms are connected to the shoulders. I mean, sometimes they look a little awkward, but you know what? Sometimes they also look kind of cool. So, Skids, is it my personal taste? Well, let's go to my overall review.
So overall, do I highly recommend Transformers Dark of the Moon Skids? Absolutely-ish. Only-ish. I do see a little less complexity from the previous Revenge of the Fallen versions. Then again, this one does feel a little bit more like it's gonna break. It does have more of the aesthetics that it's a kind of a wacky figure. The previous versions were more... I want to say humanoid, but more average. These ones are a little different, so they're a little bit more unique. However, they don't really scream like the movie versions either. So, you know what? It's up to you. Whatever you want to buy. I'm the Canadian Reviewer. I'm going to read some bacon!